In this video, we're given two vectors in polar form, and that means what we know about them is their magnitude and their direction. In part A, we're asked to decompose these two vectors into their x and y components. And then in part B, we're going to use those components to find the vector sum of these two vectors. And then we're going to express that vector sum back in polar form. So let's knock out those components real quick. I'll start with F1, and we visualize this little right triangle to break it into components. Geometrically, its x component is this guy pointing to the right, and the y component is this guy pointing up. And we call those f1x and f1y. Now, because f1x comes from the adjacent side of this right triangle, we're going to get that with the cosine function. So that's 85 cosine 71 degrees. And f1y, that's 85 sine 71 degrees. Then we do a similar thing with f2. We draw this projection onto the x-axis that makes a right triangle. Our x component points to the left. Our y component points down. Both of these are in the negative direction for the coordinate system, so they'll take minus signs. And the length of that adjacent side, that x component, is a 70 cosine 35, but we're going to put a minus sign on it. So that's f2x. And then f2y is a 70 sine 35 with a minus sign. So I run the numbers on f1x, that's 85 cosine 71. This gives me 27.7 newtons. f1y, that's 85 sine 71. This gives me 80.4 newtons. f2x, negative 70 cosine 35. This gives me a negative 57.3 newtons. Again, the minus sign indicates this leftward direction. And f2y, that's negative 70 sine 35. That gives me a negative 40.2 newtons, where the minus sign indicates the downward direction. Now we simply add up all the x direction components. I have 27.7 pointing to the right. I have 57.3 pointing to the left. That leftward component wins here. That's bigger than the rightward component. So my net x component will take a minus sign. And I'll write down like f net x is 27.7 minus 57.3. And this gives me negative 29.6 newtons. And f net y, that's 80.4 newtons minus a 40.2 newton downward component. This gives me a positive 40.2 newtons. Now that we have the total x component and the total y component, we can draw a triangle to visualize this. And in that triangle, I've got my 29.6 newton leftward pointing component. I have my 40.2 newton upward pointing component. And what we're after here is the angle of that resultant vector relative to the x-axis, and also the magnitude of it, which I'll call f net. So to get f net, we plug into the Pythagorean theorem. The length of the hypotenuse is the square root of the sum of the squares of the legs. And this gives me 49.9 newtons. And then the angle theta, that's the angle whose tangent is 40.2 over 29.6. In other words, the inverse tangent, 40.2 over 29.6. And this gives me 53.6 degrees. So now we've answered the question, but I want to do one more thing. I want to see that the geometric vector addition makes sense in the diagram. So I'm going to pick up F2 and paste the tail of that onto the head of F1. And then I draw the resultant vector from the tail of the first to the head of the second. And what we're looking for here is just plausibility. Does this look about right for the numbers that we got? So is the length of this about 50 newtons? Well, F2 was 70 newtons. I can see that that's a bit longer than Fnet in my picture. Definitely plausible. Fnet is 50, so that's good. What about the angle? In my picture, it looks a tiny bit bigger than 45 degrees. The numerical answer we got was 53.6 degrees, so we're happy with that too. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.